Yeah, you have a beautiful place. I want to show you guys this mountain back here.
Yeah.
Welcome back to another Axe Family video. Hope you're doing well. Hope you have a smile on your face because it's a beautiful, beautiful day today. We are here at the Real Martian's house, and this is the Real Martian himself.
Hi, everybody. Yeah, my name's Jeff. My wife and I, we built this crazy sustainable energy and food facility here in Washington State, and got our own YouTube channel at therealmartian.com, and been sharing our journey with everybody as we go.
We were able to come out here to their property and to see everything. I actually came out here before. Yeah, everything has changed so much even since then. So this project that I told you guys about is progressing very quickly, and it's very exciting. And so why don't you tell us kind of more, maybe in depth, about what it is this project is.
It really started about 9 years ago. Started doing some research on sustainable living and living off the grid. My dad was a really big influence in my life. I'd actually left the Air Force and come home, and 6 months after I came home, he was diagnosed with terminal cancer. And 6 months after that, he had passed away. And it really was a big motivation to kind of understand, yeah, you know, life is short. And he was only 65, never smoked, no asbestos, you know, but he got lung cancer and passed away. And it was one of those moments when you realize life ends and you only have so much of it. I'm getting older myself, I turned 40 this year. You combine that with some engineering knowledge that I have, and I'm an aerospace engineer, and I wanted to be an astronaut, so
yeah.
I was chasing that dream, and then medically I couldn't do that. He had a heart challenge. Came back home, dad passed away, and I was like, man, I need to do something. So I started researching sustainable living, living off the grid, and realized it's not just about food, but it's also about power. And if you want to have some of the comforts that we've come to have today, like refrigeration, you need electricity and stuff like that. So after about 5 years of research, my wife and I did an experiment in our office. And we actually played around with aquaponics, and we learned a whole bunch. And I found out that, you know, the world's actually kind of running out of like fresh water. NASA did this big study. They flew satellites over the planet, and they found out that 2/3 of the water supply underground is emptying faster than what it can be filled. And we saw that just in, I think it was 2015, they did a study down in California, and the ground actually sank by like 2 inches. Because we're pumping so much water out of it to keep all the land wet for all the agriculture that we're doing. And then I found another study talking about our population in the year 2050. It's going to grow up to like 9.5 billion people.
Wow.
It's like 7.5 billion people a day. And the report, and I think it's pretty logical, but the report concluded that we need to increase agricultural output by 70%. And the best that we can do is 20%.
Wow.
So that's a 50% gap between what we need and what we'll be able to do. That means a lot of people aren't going to be very happy. Mm-hmm. So one night we're sitting here, we're having dinner, and you know, we're Christians, and I'm praying, giving thanks, and for years I was always praying afterwards, like, you know, and Lord, please help provide food to people who don't have any. And just one night, he's like, you know, why don't you do something about that? Mm. And I felt like I just, you know, got like whack.
Yeah.
Right up alongside the back of the head, like, oh, geez, okay, I guess I'm supposed to do something. That doesn't mean like I think I'm some savior or anything, or, you know, it's just I think he's just speaking like, well, you know, you've got arms, you've got legs, you know, obviously you care about this because you've been praying about it for so many years. Why don't you actually do something? We got that experiment going, and I talked to my wife, and we decided, let's build it. So we built this huge building, you know, 80 feet long, 40 feet wide, 22 feet tall, and we shoved everything in there. It runs aquaponics to help grow our food, and we have an anaerobic digester, which produces energy. We have solar panels, which produce more energy. We have automation that controls everything so that, you know, right now we're kind of wed to the system. But
and it's not just automation. It's automation that has software that you coded yourself.
That's correct, yeah. Yeah, I learned 7 different software languages to put the whole thing together.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Yeah. It's been quite the journey, and you know, it's had its ups and downs, but we're hoping that with this building that we built, we went big because, you know, like when they build, you know your phone, you know, everyone has a phone today. They don't start off with it that small. You know, usually it takes up like an area that big when they first lay out the circuit board, and they're just making sure everything works. Mm-hmm. And then they make it smaller and smaller and smaller, you know, until they get it to the size that they really want it to be. And it's called breadboarding.
Okay.
So we're using the same premise here. It's like, don't worry about trying to make it perfect the first time. Just go big, so you don't have to worry about optimization, because that costs a lot of money. Mm-hmm. And so we built the thing and went big with it. It can support 4 families of 4 full time. That means every day they can walk out there, grab food, come back in, feed their family, and the next day they can go out there and do it the same. And we're just, you know, the building's going and it's just starting to get the plants and everything into it. So
yeah.
We still have a lot to learn, but it's working. Mm-hmm. It's starting to do what it's supposed to do. So we're hoping once this building's done, we can actually build another one that we call Hab 2, which will make it a lot smaller.
Okay.
So we'll start, just like the phone, get a big circuit board. We'll start making ours smaller and smaller until someday, hopefully in the not too distant future, we'll be able to get it small enough to where a family of 4 could afford it and grow their own food and generate their own power right on site.
Yeah.
Send it to you know, places where they don't have food and power and can help clean water. It's kind of a cool system.
Yeah, it's very cool. And if you're not familiar with aquaponics, you actually have fish that are down underground.
Yep.
Under the lanes. And then you use that water with the fish waste to water the plants. And then that drains back down into the fish's area. And
that's
so
right.
What's coming from the plants down to the fish, if anything?
Clean water.
Okay.
Yeah, so if you go from when the fish leave their waste behind, that's in the water. So we pump that dirty water up to the grow beds. And then in the grow beds, there's red wiggler worms. And there's a bunch of bacteria, really good bacteria, the kind of bacteria that we actually live and survive off of. And it converts the fish waste into plant food. So then the plants eat the plant food that used to be fish waste, and they leave behind nice clean water. And then that clean water goes back down to the fish, and you have a nice loop.
Yeah.
So the only thing you got to put in that loop is seeds for your plants and food for your fish.
Right. And then the fish can be food.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we got rainbow trouts in there.
Yeah, that's awesome.
They taste good.
That's awesome. We appreciate you having us come over, and you're actually taking off for a couple days. And so
we are.
Taylor and I are going to attempt to run the place and do our best. And you've set us up well, so.
I think you got it. You're in control.
All right.
You got the keys to the Hab. It's all you. All
right, here we go. I'm on Mars for a couple days. Our video from yesterday and then a video from the next few days, you'll be able to see some more of just like our time here. If you haven't yet gone over to his channel, he has a bunch of content over there. He has a bunch of different videos explaining this whole process. There's one video in particular that kind of summarizes everything. That one's a really good one. Make sure you head on over there. Push the subscribe button all the way in and leave him a comment saying that you're coming from Axe Family, just to support him and his channel. We're also going to get a bigger picture of what it is that he's doing, because I can only explain so much.
Yeah.
But he goes into much more detail. If you're new to my channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button, push it all the way in, and leave us a comment down below saying hi. And thanks for watching. Hats off to you.
Well,
the sun is killer.
It is a little bright, but man, it feels good. Is that your sign off? Hats off to you?
Hats off to you.
Yeah?
Yep.
That's cool.
Kind of a way of saying like, hey, thanks for watching.
Yeah, no, it's really good.
We appreciate you.